up guys, it's Freemond here, the Dawn of Sorrow again. Let's see, we beat the back to the meeting. Yeah. But also, we got the Skeleton Arc Soul, which means we can finally get past that spiky area over the left. Right. Easy way to bypass this section. And also the only time there's a real need for the Skeleton Arc. Wizardry Lab again? First time, monkey or soul. Serenity Lord. Super potion and yeah. Oh yeah, the bloody stud. Yeah. White gold is better. Keep it rare and mature. Yeah, the money goes over here. That's 666. I'm doing a hunt, so let's go back to that room with the ghosts. I didn't realize I had quite so many known ones. Okay, 8 this section. I think it hates me. There we go. Oh gods! This is a little problem. I hate the Iron Golem, it's hard enough to beat normally. With it going all completely broken like that, it's gonna be even bloody worse. do like the holiday movies. They make, I mean, they're not exactly the most useful enemy, but they're fun in a slightly odd way. Only like, I think, two rooms where they appear. Well, that's one of them. The other one's pretty much right near the end of the game. Oh, yeah, what a gun right there. But yeah, that light is quite low, that's the normal. Yeah, there's these two statues in the Lost Village, about dribbling like that. Yeah, each of them have this, a bit of this passage hidden under them. There we go. Caviar. One of the best healing items in the game. We've got the, what do you call it? The world's three great delicacies. Duck liver paste, sturgeon eggs, and... I can't remember what the third one is. They're one of the very few items in the game fully heal you. That's what's at the end of that. Obviously we've got this other path here that leads again into the wizardry lab. That's the one. That one you have to wait until you get the Griffin Soul. That's when the village will restock. Alucard. Alucard's not interested in anyone. There's a shop. He's an number of hundreds year old here, vampire. Hidden passage. What the hell? Get back to the cursed clock tower now that we have of flight abilities. Yeah. So you get this far without it, but then you get to here. And you see the problem. Yeah, this is the exit for the clock tower. Yeah, there we go. The Master's Keep? No, the Pinnacle. Yeah, the Master's Keep a bit later. It may look like Yoko, but they're not known. Oh, Is he glitching out as well? Section of the Demon Guest House. Yes, another Ghost Dancer song. Oh, of course. Yeah, that opens passage to there. I do like with this area that we have in the latches just sort of full 4 or 5 floors. I mean, they don't take any fall damage, but it just amuses me to see them just drop with what should be the short drop to the floor and then just end up going right the way down. Wait, this is the room for layers. Iron golem here. Don't want to mess with that. The path we want is through here. Oh yeah, I need to equip this stupid wall. Axe armor. I hope I've got all the solid iron. Axe armor. Did get a killer crown, yep. Did I not? God. Okay. Well, gone and I've got up the back soul. There you are. Well, I need to set fires. Possibly one of the most useless abilities in the entire game. But, and we're on our way to this area. Yeah, the last boss battle in the guest house.
Okay, I'm back. I just had to go save. Because what we've got here is kind of a double boss battle. Against mini paranoia, and then proper paranoia. They're not exactly the same when it comes to fighting them. Except for the first one, you don't have to draw a stupid magic seal. And also for the first one, you don't get a soul. The order the mirrors flash is the order the blaze is supposed to reflect in. But then there's the direction of the very last reflection, it's always a bit. See? The important thing here is to get the paranoia soul, because that allows me to fight the proper boss instead of just fighting Dario when I get up to the throne room at the top of the pinnacle. Boom.
Paranoia plummet. Mirror smashes. So get health, get the ability to enter mirrors, which when used any time other than when I'm in front of a mirror, looks completely ridiculous. Observe. That is just a good way of wasting mana. Well, when I'm in front of a mirror, that's why there was those areas throughout the map where I didn't bother going yet, like
one of these two, that, along this path, and there's a few others. Oh yeah, that spot. They all have mirrors,
and going through the mirror gets you some bonus loot, like just beating him then got me, oh, got some very close. Yeah, Ulrox's suit, which is pretty good. But at the top corner of the sliding block puzzle over there is Dracula's tunic, which is among, if not the best, then one of the best armors in the entire game. So let's go.
Magical mirror tour. So. Top corner of the slidey puzzle. I only picked up whatever it was that was here, I can't remember, but bam, Dracula's tunic. Which, if I go to equip, see? Okay. Next. And mirror two. Just let you walk through the wall, because then you can get the tear of the blood. I'm not sure if it's actually a very good item.
Oh yeah, yeah. Better than the next one, right? Okay.
Next. Okay. Next move actually behind a whole bunch of these sort of. This one though is, you can see the ghouls in the mirror. Anyway, I think there's, I can think of one more after this, so. Okay, another mirror room, red scarf. Oh yeah, Mikey the Ord. The, yeah, the one that gives you the best attack boosts. One more, which I had completely forgotten about, which is up in the Cursed Clock Tower. The room with the many, many pendulums. There's also this room that I'd forgotten about, which needs me to throw a wall of bone. Doesn't actually have a mirror in it, but. Much earlier in the game, judging by the weapon I just found, but never mind. Okay. And the final mirror room. This was the platinum stud and some scale. Both of which are utterly useless.
That's definitely all the mirrors. God knows. As in, there's one more left at the room where they're supposed to fight Dario for the final time. I believe I managed. I don't think I've ever managed to get through that bit without taking at least a bit of damage, regardless of which way we're looking. Anyway, save.
And, refreshing, not dying repeatedly, and no major glitches. See you all next time. Bye bye.